Hi, welcome to another episode of Adobe Spotlight. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to use the new Adobe Express video tool. Let's jump right in. So here I am on the new express.adobe.com, the new Adobe Express. And this is a very powerful tool with new features being added now and then and some really powerful AI and all of these cool things. But what if you remember the old Adobe Express or even Adobe Spark and you really valued and liked the three original tools, which were video, page, and post? Well, in this video, I will focus on Adobe Express video and how to find that tool and how to use it similarly to how you used to use the Adobe Express video tool or Adobe Spark video tool. And for those of you that are new to Adobe Express, you don't need to worry about those old versions. Just watch this video and you'll learn how to use this new powerful Adobe Express video tool. So again, here I am in Adobe Express. And to make an Adobe Express video, I could click here on the plus sign in the upper left and go to video, or I could just click here on video. And that's what I'm going to do in this case. And there are different ways that you could begin making your video. If you already have video footage that you've just recently taken or that you've gotten from your camera roll or whatever it might be, you could start by uploading that video and then make edits from there. In this case though, I'm just going to select the kind of video that I am trying to create. Do I want to make a TikTok video? No, I don't. What about an Instagram reel or a YouTube video? I'm just going to go here to video, a generic video. You can see the dimensions, 1920 by 1080. And I could choose a template, but for this video, I'm just going to click Create from Scratch, and it opens up the new Adobe Express video. Now, if you're used to the old way that Adobe Express and Adobe Spark video worked, this may be a little confusing to you at first. What I have here on the screen is a preview of my video so far. It's completely blank. So I have a blank rectangle, a white rectangle here on the screen. Underneath that, I have a timeline of sorts, but it can be a little confusing for people. This is my first scene, basically, and it's 5 seconds of nothing, just a blank white rectangle. And then I have something over here that says add scene, so I can create a second scene. Here above my preview, I have some other tools. I could resize, I have a theme tool, I have background color tool. Here at the upper right, I have some other options for zoom level and some other options. There's another add button here. So we have the add scene button down here, but there's an add button here in the upper right. So be very careful about which one you choose. And I'll talk about that more in just a minute. But before I do, notice that here at the left, I have a panel with some options, some resources that I can add to my video and that I can use. Right now it's showing me videos, but if I wanted to add photos to the project, I certainly could. Also audio, and that's just media. If I click on text, I can also add text or elements, grids, add-ons. And above that, there are templates that I could apply to this project. There's my stuff as well. If I've uploaded images or videos or shapes or other things, I can pull those into my project as well. For now though, I'm just going to click back on media and I'm going to select photos in this case for my first scene. And I want this video project that I'm making to be all about the country of Chile, which is where I learned Spanish. So I get some results. And notice that some of these images are reserved for certain customers, you know, paying customers or ones that have access to more of the images. So you may or may not have access to every single picture, but you'll notice that this one here is free for any user of Adobe Express. Same with this one and this one and this one. So just be aware, you may not have access to everything that you see here, but I would like to add this image here to my project. So there it is. I can then click and drag to move it if I want to. I can resize it. And let's say I want another image for my first scene in my project. I could go back and select something else. Okay, so now I've got a couple of different images that could represent the country of Chile. and I've resized them and put them on the scene where I want them to be. Now I would like some text that says something like, "Welcome to Chile." So I could X out of the media panel, or I could just simply click here on text. That would have been a little faster, I think. And I'm going to click to add my own text. So I get a text box, and I could click and drag to select the text, and I'll type, "Welcome to Chile," and I'll click and drag to put that text exactly where I want it to be. Now, as you can see here at the left in the text panel, there are all sorts of different options for that text. I could have the text show up in different shapes, different ways, different styles, but I'm just going to undo those changes. I could hold Control and tap Z to undo it, or just use this button here in the upper part of Adobe Express. Okay, there's my first scene in my Adobe Express video. But before I go on, I would like to add at least one more element to my Adobe Express video. I want to add my voice. So I'm going to click here at the left on Media, and it takes me back to the Photos area. But in this case, I want audio. I want my own voice to be added to this. Let's say I've already recorded my voice or someone else's voice, and it's saved as a WAV file or an MP3 file. I very well may be able to just upload it directly into the project. But in this case, I want to record it right now. So I'll click Record VoiceOver. I've given permission for Adobe Express to access my microphone. And now I'll click Start Recording. And I get a countdown. "Welcome to Chile. This video is all about the country of Chile." I click Finish Recording. And you can now see that here on the timeline of sorts, I have not only my scene that I've designed, but I have a voiceover, VoiceOver 1. And I can click play.
"Welcome to Chile. This video is all about the..."
to get a sense of the results of my work. Now notice underneath this timeline, there's a button that I can switch on, and that will now show the layer timing. So now I could select a layer and I could change the timing of that layer. I could shorten up the end of the clip, or I could click and drag to move that audio clip so that it starts later or starts earlier on the timeline. Okay, so let's say I'm now ready to create the next part of my Adobe Express video. What should I do? Should I click here on Add Scene, or should I go up here to the upper right and click the Add button? This is very important. In almost every case, you should not go here to the Add button. Instead, just click Add Scene and proceed to continue to develop and create your Adobe Express video. So I'm going to go back here to Media, and this time I want to add some videos of Chile. Now these are just going to be really short videos. So there I've got a 22-second video, and I'm going to click to add it as my next scene in Adobe Express video. So there it is. This is footage of Santiago, Chile, and now it's my second scene, basically, in my Adobe Express video. Again, I could adjust the timing of the video, the length of the video. I could even click and drag to put it at the beginning of my overall project, or in the middle, or at the end. However I want to reorder that scene is fine. Once again, if I want to, I can record my voice. So I'm going to go here again to Media, but this time not videos, but audio. And I'll record a voiceover. I'll click Start Recording. I get my countdown. This is footage of the capital city of Chile called Santiago. It is a vast city with many different neighborhoods and millions of people living in this giant city. So I click Finish Recording. And there's my audio voiceover. It's been added to my project. I could adjust the timing just by clicking and dragging to make it begin and end at the exact time that I would like it to. So imagine me continuing to add scene after scene. Some might have text, some might just have images, photos, some may have videos. Some will have audio voiceovers, some may not. I could even add things like elements. So these are design elements, shapes in some cases, illustrations. In some cases, they are animations. But I could continue to add those things to my project, adjusting the timing, adjusting how long they're on the screen. And I could just continue to do that until my Adobe Express video is done. I'm happy with my project. I'm ready to be finished with it. Before I show you how to finish off the project and be done with it and share it with others, perhaps, let me just talk about this add button in the upper right corner. I said previously in this video that you almost never want to click that button. In almost every case, you just want to work here on the timeline and add scene after scene until you're done with your video. So then what is this add button? If you click on this add button, it lets you add a new page. And that sounds interesting. You know, instead of just working on this one page of my video, I may want to add a second page, and I'll make it the same size. The problem with doing this is you end up not with a second scene or a second part of your video. Instead, you end up with basically a separate video. So here at the top right, you can see I'm on page 2 now. If I click, I can go back to page 1 and continue to work on the video that's on page 1. But if I create a second page and put some material on that second page, when it's time to share my video, I will end up with a separate video here, separate from the one I did on page 1. And so in a lot of cases, this idea of pages in a video, like, it doesn't really work for many people. It doesn't really make a lot of sense because you just end up with two separate videos. And so I would recommend that you avoid using this add page button unless you really want to experiment with it and create basically two separate videos that are connected in some way. They're part of the same project, but they're on separate pages. Notice that if you really want to, you can use this button to just add another scene to this current video, and that's okay to do. That's basically the same thing as if you had clicked this button, add scene. So now that I do have another scene, I'm gonna go ahead and I'll put in some text. This time, instead of just adding generic text, I'm going to use some of this pre-made text. I just clicked on it to add it to my project, and now I can click on the various elements, even double click or triple click. I'll type in thanks. I'll double click on mom, and I've typed in thanks for watching. I'll center that better. And to make it easier to see that text, I'm just gonna quickly change the background color for this scene. I'll just make it a dark green. But as you can see, there are many other options that you could choose. You can go to custom and get the exact background color that you want. Okay, so let's say I'm done with my video project. How do I finish this off and turn it in or send it to someone, publish it in some way? The first thing to do is to name my project. So here in the upper left corner, I'm gonna click and I'll name this whatever I want to. How about Welcome to Chile? Now that I've named it, I can easily just click download, and what will happen is Adobe Express will let me download the selected page or all pages. I'm gonna go with all pages so you can see what happens in that case. And it's going to download my project in the file format that I choose. So I want this to be a video. Out of these four options, MP4 is the only one that is a video. So I'll stick with that. The resolution has been predetermined for me, so I'll click download. And now my project, in this case, including both pages of my project, is beginning to download to my computer. Okay, it's finished downloading. Let's open it up. And here are the results of my download. I had a project with two pages, and what it did is it downloaded each of those two pages separately. And so again, that's why I don't recommend using additional pages in your video projects. Just put everything that you want to be in your video project on the same page and work that way. So here's the result. I can click play. I'll mute the audio, but here is my video. It's downloaded to my computer. It's a real video that works without anyone having access to Adobe Express. So I'm gonna X out of that video, and I'll X out of this downloads folder. The other way to share a video project is to click the share button in the upper right. And when you click it, you can do one of several things. It is possible to invite collaborators to work with you on a particular project. So a coworker of mine or a fellow student could work with me as I develop this video, but they could be on their own computer. Another option is to publish this project to the web. When I click Publish Link, Adobe Express works to publish my project, and it will provide me with a link that I could send to people. Anyone that clicks that link will be able to watch my video project. Here I have the notice that my link is ready. If I make any changes to my project, I will need to update the link. But for now, I'll just click Copy Link. I could paste that into an email, paste it into Canvas, or on a public website. Anywhere that that link is, if people click on it, they'll be able to watch my video project. Other share options I have include scheduling a post. So I could schedule a Facebook, Instagram, X, Pinterest, any of these other options for social media posts, and that video would be posted to one of those channels on the appropriate day and time. There are also options for sharing video projects through Google Classroom or Microsoft Teams. So those are the basics and a little more of how to use the new Adobe Express video tool. I hope that this has been helpful and that you'll be able to use this, whether you're a teacher or a student, to create educational videos for your projects.